all your sweets. I try, but I can't figure out. I've been next to you all night and still don't know what you're about. You keep talking, but not much coming out your mouth. Can't you tell that I want to the C, to the H, to the L-E-E-E, Just Chloe. Hey everyone, welcome back to Just Chloe. It's me, Chloe, and today we're going to be doing another read aloud. So we're going to be reading two books in one. But these are just tiny little books from McDonald's Happy Meal, so yeah. So these are the same series. The series is called The Tiny Detectives. So which book should we read first? Any, mini, miny, mo, catch a tiger by its toe. If he hollers, let him go. Any, mini, miny, mo. This one. So, this book is called The Tiny Detectives. Can Animals Walk on Water? Okay, so these are inspirational books. Well, you can learn stuff about, like, animals. Also, go check out my other channel. Which is also my first channel that I ever started, called Chloe Liu, where I did a video of reading all these books, The Treetop Twins Wilderness Adventures. Check out that video if you want to. By the time I post this video, I don't know if this video will already be posted or not. I don't know. But if it is posted already, check it out. If it's not, you have to stay tuned. All right. Belongs to Chloe L. Here we go. Let's see. Can animals walk on water? So let's meet the tiny detectives. The tiny detectives are very little indeed. They're also very curious. That's why they live in a bookcase, because even the littlest of people can find answers to big questions if they dive into a book, and that is exactly what the tiny detectives do best. So, this is Ollie, this is Dad, this is Mom, this is Tyga, this is Bo, and this is their pet beetle. Super tiny. Here we go. Oh my god, look how tiny they are. One day, Bo was watching the rain come down outside when he thought of a big question. Are there any animals that can walk on water? Don't be silly, Bo, replied Ollie, who is the eldest/oldest, so he always thought he knew best. Walking on water is impossible. We'll see, said Mom. Let's jump into a book and find out. So the tiny detectives climbed the bookcase, and Mom picked out a book called Rivers of Central America. Dad wound the red story thread around his waist so they could get back out of the book at the end of their adventure, and they leapt right into the heart of the story, landing on a great leaf floating gently on the ripples of a river. Over there, cried Tyga, I can see creatures with long legs walking on the water. Those are water striders, explained Dad, as they rowed towards the graceful insects. Water has a skin called surface tension, and the water striders are so light it holds them up. Look, even their pets there. Sure enough, the water striders made little dents in the water as their feet pressed into it, but they never broke through. It's as if they're running on a trampoline, said Tyga. So animals can walk on water, said Bo. Insects don't count, said Ollie. How about this water snail, said Mom, pointing downwards, slithering just underneath the surface of the water as if it were... Ugh, I hate snails, and I hate slugs. Sliding upside down on a ceiling was a snail. It clung to the surface tension with a sticky trail of muckus. Wow, that's incredible, gasped Tyga. Snails don't count either, said Ollie, extremely upset to be wrong. They don't walk, they slither. Oh my god, he's too stubborn. But just then, Dad noticed a large spotted lizard with a spine on its back like a sail running straight at them. "Row out of the way," shouted Dad. "That's a, I don't know how to say that, lizard," panted Mom as they rowed away as fast as they could. "It has flaps of skin on its feet, which can spread out to create little pockets of air. These keep the lizard afloat long enough to take the next step. It can't stop running through or it will sink." The green lizard ran past them so fast it created a wave. The tiny detective's boat began to rock. The leaf tipped all the way to one side, and Beetle flew and Beetle fell overboard into the water. Beetle drifted away on his back, his legs wriggling. Ollie bravely jumped after him, but he couldn't swim fast enough to catch the floating Beetle. And then Bo leaped out of the boat and ran towards Beetle. Is he walking on water? Bo was so small and light that, like the water stritter, the surface tension supported him. He caught Beetle by his antenna and dragged him back to the leaf boat. It was just in time as Dad spotted a big fish shooting towards them with its mouth open. Oh no. Dad threw the story thread towards the others and they gave 1, 2, 3 tugs, and the tiny detectives were pulled up through the watery pages of the book back into the peaceful warmth of their very own bookcase. Dad grinned. "So some lizards can walk on water," he said as Ollie dried himself off grumpily. "And the tiny detectives too, but only the very smallest ones." The end. All right, last book. This is called "Is There Life at the Bottom of the Deepest Ocean?" Let's see. Oh, you can see. You can see my camera. So, of course, we have Meet the Tiny Detectives again. This time, the picture is different. One rainy day, Ollie, who was the eldest of the tiny detective children, asked a big question. Is there life at the bottom of the deepest ocean? "Let's jump into a book and find out the answer," said Mom. "Don't forget to put on your diving suits, everyone." So the tiny detectives put on their diving suits, and they climbed on the bookcase, and Dad picked out a book called Life in the Ocean Deep. Ow. Then he wound the red story thread around his waist so they could get back out of the story at the end of their adventure. And they leapt right down and down. Down into the Marina Trench? Yeah. "The Marina Trench is the deepest part of the ocean," said Mom. "At its deepest point, it is almost 11,000 meters below sea level." Wow. "Beetle's a bit worried that there might be big and scary fish down there," said Bo. "Well, it's true. We're likely to see some very interesting creatures," said Dad. Dad was right. The further down they went, the more fascinating things became. "Oh, look," said Tiger, pointing. "That's the smallest octopus I've ever seen. And it has ears." "Yes, that's a Dumbo octopus," explained Mom. "It flaps through. It's so cute. And it's pink. Or like this little pink. The water like a little flying elephant." "Okay, that one's not very scary," admitted Bo. "And look at that one," Taiga said in wonder. "A fish that has a transparent head." Sure enough, a beautiful fish swam past. It has a transparent head so that it can see the fish swimming above it, explained Dad. "Isn't nature extraordinary? Every creature was more amazing than the last." Oh my gosh, what kind of a fish is that? What? Wow. "What other creatures do you see in there?" Those jellyfish look like underwater rainbows, said Taiga as calm jellies wafted past them, their bodies and long tentacles turning different colors as they swam.
It's so pretty. It looks like Christmas lights.
Wow. Look how beautiful the color of the ocean is that they made. It's like a purplish bluish color. It's very pretty. Down, down they went until Dad pointed out a fish that was so frail and delicate they could you could barely see it. The earthel snailfish, breathed Dad, lives deeper than any other fish in the whole world, and it's kind of sweet, said Taiga. It's pink and not much bigger than us, but it can survive pressure equal to the weight of 1,600 elephants, said Mom. Isn't that extraordinary? I think this is the deepest a fish can live, though, and we're still a few thousand meters from the bottom.
Look at that fish.
It looks silly. They have found, oh my god. They have found out the answer to the big question. So Dad gave three big tugs on the story thread and up, up they went through the waters. But as they went, they bumped into a fish that was much bigger than the earthel snailfish and a lot less sweet. An anglerfish, said Dad. See, it's got a light at the end of its tentacle that attracts a little fish. Extraordinary! Bo was so surprised. He let go of the story thread and started.
Why did he let go? And oh my gosh, I know these fish. I don't like them.
Why did he let go of the story thread? Drifting towards the anglerfish. But luckily, Ollie had his umbrella with him. Taiga grabbed the umbrella and flapped it at the anglerfish as if it were the ears of a Dumbo octopus, and it frightened the anglerfish away. Dad grabbed Bo's arm, and they all clung on to the story thread as they pulled them up, 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 all the way back to the top of their very own bookcase. Another case solved for the tiny detectives, said Dad with satisfaction. So there is life nearly at the bottom of the deepest ocean, but not quite as far down as the very deepest point. And although some of the creatures were big and scary, said Bo, some of them were almost as tiny as a tiny detective. And just as extraordinary, said Mom. The end. Oh, there's a challenge here. It says, search and find. Can you find beetle hiding in the ocean? Did I see beetle? I see it. He's right there. See little beetle? He's mixing with the purple. But I see him. I saw him the minute I turned the page. Ta-da! And then there's always like little things you can do. Draw your own jellyfish. Alright, the end. So that's the end for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, like and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video. Much love. Bye, everyone.